Good morning, and good morning to our Wernel congregation as they worship with the simulcast. We have a very special treat for you this morning. If you would, look in your bulletins, there's a little flyer in here. This flyer was created by folks who speak Spanish and did a very good job of communicating in English. They brought this with them. If you'll just look at the back of this, this is a precious picture. This is Pablo Sr., who 30 years ago had a vision for a Christian school where children of the very poor community where he lived would be educated, would hear about Jesus, and he had no idea how that was going to happen. And at the same time, the Lord had put upon the hearts of a couple young whippersnappers here at Colonial to take a drive in a bus through the country of Guatemala to see what God had in store for them. It literally worked like that 30 years ago. And since that time, Colonial has been in partnership with what has become called Colegio Mark. It's an amazing school. I've been there. It is, if you've not been, how many of you have been to Colegio Mark in our church? If you look around, there's a lot of folks who have been. There's a lot more hands that need to go up. I hope that you will go. But today, for the first time ever, we have members of Pablo's family. Pablo passed away 2 years ago, 2010. But his son, Pablo Jr., is here. And his other son, Jacino, let me introduce you real quickly. For those of you at Wernel, we'll be there at 11, but I want to show you who they are. So Jacinto, if you would stand, and his wife, Velma, and their daughter, Raquel, are here. And then I'm going to invite Pastor Pablo and his interpreter, Mario, to come up. Now, Mario is not from Nintendo. Although he could have been the first Mario. I mean, you put the bibs on there, it would have worked. Just a little bit of information about these wonderful people. First, Mario's been raised in a Christian home and studied at Living Waters Bible Institute. He'll soon graduate with a degree in computer science. He began working with our Colonial Mission Team 7.5 years ago as a translator, helping Pastor Phil, who is here at our first service. And he also works with Agua Viva, a Living Waters ministry team, which has many Colonial members in it, including Jim and Nancy Allen. And Jim Allen lost his mom this week, and I'm sure is not able to be here today. Jim's not here. Yeah, so we miss him, and but we're praying for that family. But Pablo has served, you know, ever since he was born. Colegio Mark was in existence, really. Well, for 24 years, he served as an educator at Colegio Mark. He has studied at the theology, studied theology in the seminary in Guatemala, and in June 2010, after the passing away of his father, he took over pastoring the church that Pablo Sr. started some time ago. I want to also recognize, if you've been paying attention to the paper, that just 2 hours north of where they live, there's been a tremendous earthquake, 7.2 or 7.4. And many, many people have died. So we need to keep their country in our prayers for any number of reasons. So let's give Pablo a warm Colonial welcome as he comes to share the gospel with us this morning.
Es el segundo servicio.
Very happy to be here in the second service.
Y por segunda vez.
And for second time.
No entendí lo que el pastor dijo de mí.
One more time and didn't understand what he was saying.
Espero algún día poder entender
eso. But someday I will. I know someday I will.
Cuando viajé para su país, que es un país muy hermoso.
When I was traveling to come to the U.S., which, by the way, is a very, very beautiful country.
Estaba tomando las fotografías de mi papá.
I was taking the pictures of my dad when I was getting ready.
Mi padre hace años estuvo acá con ustedes.
And my dad, a few years ago, he was here in the Colonial.
Y estaba buscando y dije, ¿qué fotografía me llevo de él?
And I was looking for a picture of him.
Él fue mi maestro de teología.
Because he was one of my best teachers in theology.
Él me enseñó a buscar al Señor.
He teach me how to seek for the Lord.
Y me traje una fotografía donde él está celebrando la cena del Señor.
So I took a picture when he is actually giving the communion.
Y yo no me imaginaba que hoy también ustedes estaban celebrando
al
Señor.
I didn't know that today you will have communion too.
No cabe duda que el Espíritu trabaja.
But I know that that was God's will.
Por eso esta mañana vamos nosotros a deleitarnos en la palabra del Señor.
So this morning we want to enjoy the word of the Lord.
Y quiero invitarlo a usted en esta mañana.
So I want you to join me.
Para que abra en el libro de Primera de Corintios.
In 1 Corinthians.
9:24.
Chapter 9, verse 24.
Una interrogación muy grande para cada uno de nosotros.
And this is a great question for each one of us.
Y la interrogante dice así.
And the word of God says like this.
¿No sabéis que los que corren en el estadio?
You don't know that those who run in the stadium.
Todos a la verdad corren.
Everybody's running.
Pero uno solo se lleva el premio.
But only one will win the race.
Corran de esa manera.
So therefore, run in this way.
Para que obtengan el premio.
That you may win that race and get the prize.
Los griegos.
The Greek people.
Eran muy reconocidos por sus olimpiadas.
They were really known for the Olympics.
Ellos tenían tres frases muy especiales.
And they always say these three things.
Y esas frases estaban distribuidas a lo largo del camino.
And during this race, they also keep saying these three things.
Y mientras que ellos iban corriendo,
and between the fact they have a running,
iban encontrando esas frases.
They will see these phrases all over the place.
Y esta frase primera es muy importante.
And the first thing that they will find was this.
La frase dice, tú eres hombre.
The first thing says is, you are a man.
Les hacía recordar a ellos que mientras iban corriendo,
and that what reminded to them between the fact that they were running,
su cuerpo podía estar fatigado,
that maybe they get tired,
pero les decían, tú eres hombre, tú puedes hacerlo.
But the people was yelling at them, you are a man, you can do it.
La segunda frase decía,
and the second thing that they found out on the way,
esfuérzate,
is get effort.
Para poder llegar a la meta hay que hacer un esfuerzo.
In order to you to reach your goal, you need to effort yourself.
Y eso es lo que ellos les recordaban a sus competidores.
And that's what was people yelling at the side of the track.
Pero la tercera frase,
but the third thing that they were yelling to the people who was running on the
los
track,
los animaba más a seguir adelante.
Give it really encouragement.
Apresúrate.
They would say, hurry up.
No pierdas el tiempo.
Don't lose your time.
No te rindas.
Don't give up.
Hay que seguir adelante.
You need to keep going.
El apóstol Pablo,
Paul the apostle,
nos trae para nosotros en el presente,
keep these words for us in the present,
este verso tan hermoso,
and he wrote this beautiful verse,
que aún en signos de interrogación,
that even with a question mark,
pero nos da ese ánimo para seguir adelante.
He tried to give us that encouragement to keep going.
No saben que los que corren en el estadio,
do you don't know that those who race in a stadium,
a la verdad todos corren,
everybody's running,
pero solo uno lleva el premio,
but only one will win the race.
¿Cuántos queremos ese premio?
How many want to win the prize?
El apóstol Pablo no estaba diciendo que solo un premio hay.
Paul the apostle wasn't saying there is only one prize.
Sino los estaba animando.
But he was encouraging you.
A que creyeran.
Do you believe?
Que ese premio tenía que ser solo para uno.
That prize is for you.
De hecho, en todas las carreras.
Actually, in every single race.
Siempre hay una medalla especial para el primer lugar.
They always have a very special medal for the first place.
Posiblemente los demás tengan obsequios.
Maybe for the other people they have gifts, I don't know.
Pero el primer lugar es importante.
But who win the race, who get in the first place is very important.
Por lo tanto.
Therefore.
El apóstol Pablo nos insta en esta mañana.
Paul the apostle gives us encouragement this morning.
A correr.
To use the run.
A obtener ese premio.
To win that prize.
Posiblemente en el camino.
Maybe in the way.
Nosotros vayamos a encontrar situaciones difíciles.
You may have found very difficult situations.
Y de hecho lo hemos encontrado.
And maybe you already did.
Pero el libro de Corintios nos dice.
But the book of Corinthians says.
Afligidos en todo.
Nobody if you're afflicted in everything.
Pero no angustiados.
But don't get worried.
En apuros.
Maybe you are in problems.
Pero no desesperados.
But don't go down.
Perseguidos.
Maybe somebody is persecuting you.
Pero no desamparados.
But nobody's going to leave you alone.
Derribados.
Maybe you are down.
Pero no destruidos.
But you are not destroyed.
Creí, por tanto hablé.
I believe, so therefore I talk.
El apóstol nos recuerda a cada uno de nosotros.
Paul the apostle reminds us.
Que tenemos una meta enfrente.
There is a goal in front of you.
Y que tenemos que alcanzarla.
And you need to reach that goal.
¿Cuántos quieren alcanzar esa meta?
How many wants to reach that goal?
Pero no solo alcanzarla, sino atreverse a pasar en
but
ella.
But not just reach the goal, but win the race.
Cada uno de nosotros tiene un número.
Each one of us have a number.
No sé cuál sea el número de usted para correr esta mañana.
I don't know what is your number to identify you as a runner this morning.
Posiblemente sea el 1, el 24, el 30, no sé.
Maybe it's 1, maybe it's 24, maybe it's 30, I don't know.
Pero yo lo animo en el nombre del Señor.
But I want to encourage you in the name of Jesus.
A seguirse ejercitando.
To keep exercise yourself.
Pero no es ejercicio material.
But this is not a physical exercise.
Sino el ejercicio espiritual.
It's a spiritual exercise.
A seguir leyendo la palabra.
Keep reading the word.
A seguir orando.
Keep praying.
A seguir orando.
Keep praying.
A seguir orando.
Keep praying.
Y a buscar la presencia del Espíritu Santo.
Seek for the presence of the Holy Spirit.
Ahí en lo más íntimo de tu hogar.
Right there in the most intimate place of your home.
Ahí encerrado, como dice la palabra, más tú cuando ores.
As the word of God says, when you go to pray,
cierra tu puerta,
close the door,
ora a tu padre que está en secreto,
pray your father who sees you in the secret,
y tu padre que está en secreto,
and your father who sees you in the secret,
te va a recompensar en público,
will reward you in the public.
Es palabra del Señor.
That's the promise of the Lord.
¿Está contento por eso?
Are you happy for this?
Todos como cristianos estamos frente a una competencia.
Every one of us as a Christians are in a race.
Pero tenemos que reconocer que esa competencia no es una competencia cualquiera.
But we don't recognize that this race is not just any kind of race.
En la pista siempre van a haber obstáculos, hermanos.
You will find obstacles on the track.
Pero el Señor prometió.
But the Lord promised you.
Cuando pases por las aguas.
When you pass through the water.
Yo estaré contigo.
I will be with you.
Cuando pases por el fuego.
When you pass through the fire.
No te vas a quemar.
You won't burn.
Porque yo estoy contigo.
Because I'm with you.
Estamos conscientes entonces que nuestra vida cristiana,
so in a Christian life,
está lleno de obstáculos, hermanos.
We will find many obstacles.
Posiblemente sea enfermedad.
Maybe you will find sickness.
Posiblemente sea escasez.
Maybe you will have a lack of something.
Situación económica.
Maybe your economy is not very good.
Posiblemente hasta sea un desánimo espiritual en nuestra vida.
Or maybe you are feeling depressed and you're feeling down.
Pero el apóstol dice,
but Paul the apostle says,
corre de tal manera,
run in such way,
para que tú obtengas ese premio,
that you win the race.
Esa es nuestra esperanza de fe.
That is our hope.
Poder llegar a esa meta.
Reach our goal.
Jesús también corrió.
Jesus ran the same race.
Y corrió por cada uno de nosotros.
And he ran for you.
Corrió por mí.
He ran for me.
Corrió por usted.
And he ran because of you.
Y llegando a la meta le decía al Padre.
And when he reached the goal, he says the Father.
Padre, todo está cumplido.
Father, everything is done.
Llegué a la meta.
I reached my goal.
Si yo pude.
If I can.
Mis hijos también van a
surely
poder.
My child will also can.
Nos anima a seguir corriendo, hermano.
He gives us encouragement to keep running.
Todo obstáculo que encontremos en el camino.
Every obstacle that you find on your way.
Va a formar en nosotros carácter.
Is there for forming in yourself the character of Christ.
Ese obstáculo va a formar confianza.
That obstacle is going to form confidence in the Lord.
Va a aumentar nuestra fe.
It's going to strengthen your faith.
Para buscar más la presencia del Señor.
To seek for the presence of our Lord.
Sin embargo.
But not whatsoever.
No debemos de sentirnos solos.
If you're feeling alone, you are not alone.
Porque como dice el Salmo 91,
because in Psalms 91 says,
el bien y la misericordia me seguirán todos los días de mi vida.
The good and the mercy will follow me every single day of my life.
La confianza que tenemos en el Señor,
the confidence that we have in the Lord,
nos va a permitir,
will allow us,
que cada obstáculo,
that every obstacle,
sea de beneficio.
Take every obstacle as a benefit
para nuestra vida espiritual.
For your spiritual life.
Si nos debilitamos,
if you feel weak,
se va a manifestar la potencia del Señor en nuestra vida.
The strength of the Lord is going to come to your life.
Escuche esto porque me impresiona bastante.
This is something that really impressed my life.
Cada vez de que nosotros vayamos corriendo,
every time that you are in a race,
debemos de tener presente,
you need to keep in mind,
que aquel que inició la obra en nosotros,
that the one who started the good work in us,
la va a ir perfeccionando en el camino,
it will make it perfect in the
way, a manera de que nosotros podamos sentir,
so in that way you can feel,
que no estamos solos,
that you are not alone,
nunca hemos estado solos,
and you're never going to be alone.
El Espíritu del Señor está presente,
the Spirit of the Lord is with you,
y sobre todo la comunión de la presencia del Señor está en esta mañana,
and the fellowship with the presence of the Lord is in here in this morning.
Siga orando.
I encourage you to keep praying.
Siga pidiendo por sus hijos.
Keep asking for your child.
Cada uno de nosotros va a tener que entregar.
Every one of us will have to present himself.
El número con el cual nosotros competimos.
The number when you identify yourself as a runner.
Para poder decirle a nuestros hijos.
And you can tell your child.
Hijo, yo corrí por el Señor.
My son, I have a race for the Lord.
Yo fui a las naciones.
I went to the nations.
Yo estuve en Guatemala.
I was in Guatemala.
Yo estuve en Canadá.
I went to Canada.
Yo estuve en México.
I went to Mexico.
Hijo mío.
My son.
Te toca correr para llegar a la meta.
Now it's your turn to run.
Esa es nuestra herencia para nuestros hijos.
That's your best heritage for your kids.
Y sobre todo, hermano,
but most of all,
yo lo animo esta mañana,
I want to encourage you this morning,
a seguir buscando la presencia del Señor.
To keep looking for the presence of our Lord.
Nos hace falta mucho para llegar.
It's a long way to go yet.
O quizá poco.
Or maybe it's a short time, I don't know.
Pero mientras estemos en la competencia,
but if you are running,
tenemos que seguir confiados.
You have to keep your confidence.
Y con ese ánimo.
And you have to get encourage yourself.
De alcanzar la meta.
For reach that goal.
No cabe duda entonces.
I have no doubts.
Que el apóstol Pablo.
The Paul the apostle.
Tuvo esa necesidad de escribirle a los corintios.
He felt the need to write this letter to the Corinthians.
Y les da un ejemplo tan sencillo.
And he gave us a very simple example.
Pero es un ejemplo comprometedor.
But it was a strong example.
Es un ejemplo que lleva pasión.
It's an example that takes passion in it.
Y le dice a los corintios.
And he said to the Corinthians.
Corran de esa manera.
Run in such way.
Para que alcancen la meta.
Or you can reach the goal.
Por lo tanto.
Therefore.
Aquel que comenzó en nosotros el inicio de la carrera,
the one who start with us and the beginning of the race,
va a darnos las provisiones,
will give you everything that we need,
para que cada obstáculo,
to overcome every obstacle,
sea más fácil a la par de él.
And every time that you pass an obstacle, the next one is going to be easier.
Llegará a ser a nuestro cuerpo. Llegará sed a nuestro cuerpo.
Termina la frase.
Y nosotros continuaremos adelante.
It will move you in such a way that you will finish this race and you won't even notice.
Tendremos palabra del Señor.
You will have word from the Lord.
Para poder fortalecernos.
To strengthen yourself.
Para poder caminar.
To walk in this way.
Y para poder seguir adelante.
And to reach your goal.
Dígale a la persona que está a su lado.
I want you to look at the person who's next to you.
Corre.
And say, run.
Corre.
They said, run.
Te espera una corona.
It's like a crown is waiting for you.
Los griegos cuando competían.
When the Greeks put themselves in this competition.
Estaban muy alegres por una corona natural.
They were very excited about the natural crown they were received.
Que en 15 días se arruinaba.
But in 2 weeks that crown just get destroyed.
Pero la corona que tiene el Señor para nosotros.
But the crown that the Lord has for you.
Es especial.
It's very special.
Es duradera.
Because it will last forever. It never gets ruined.
Siempre confiemos en el Señor.
Always trust in the Lord.
Quiero que en esta mañana.
I want to ask you this morning.
Se ponga de pie.
Please stand up.
Que levante las manos.
Please raise your hands to heaven.
Así como un corredor.
Like when a runner wins the race.
Cuando estamos para llegar a la meta.
When they're about to reach the goal.
Levantamos las manos.
They raise the hands.
Nos sentimos campeones.
And they feel like they are the champions of the world.
Y vemos atrás.
And they look back.
¿Quién viene?
Who is behind me?
Pero mire atrás.
But look behind you.
¿Cuántos vienen tras de usted?
How many is coming after you?
Corra de esa manera.
Run in such way.
Para que usted pueda obtener el premio.
That you may win the prize.
El apóstol no está diciendo que no hay premios para todos.
Paul the apostle is not saying that it's not prize for everybody.
Solamente quiere motivarlo esta mañana.
But he wants to encourage you this morning.
Para que usted corra.
For you run.
Corra.
Run.
Corra.
Run.
Para el Señor.
For the Lord.
Cierre los ojos, por favor.
Que los sientes.
¿Quiere extender sus manos de esta manera?
Please put your hands this way.
Y vamos a orarle al Señor.
And let's pray to the Lord.
Padre, en el nombre de Jesús.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
Te damos gracias, Señor.
We want to say thank you, Lord.
Por todas tus bondades.
For all your kindness.
Por la unción de tu Espíritu.
For the anointing of the Holy
Porque
Ghost.
Entonces creemos que no estamos solos.
Because we know that we are not alone.
Sino que Padre bendito.
But Heavenly Father.
Tu Santo Espíritu está con nosotros.
Your Holy Ghost is with us.
De esta forma extendemos nuestras manos.
We have our hands extended to you.
Para recibirte, Señor.
To receive you, Lord.
Recibir nuestras provisiones.
To receive our provision.
El camino es largo.
We know there is a long way to go.
Pero tú vas a estar con nosotros.
But you will be with us.
Gracias.
Thank you.
Amén.
Amen.
A seguir corriendo.
Keep running.
Pablo Jr., thank you for that message that there's a...